Tony Farmer's talent on the basketball court made the Garfield Heights High School senior one of the top college recruits in the country.
The defendant shall serve a term of 3 years, which is the minimum.
But the 18-year-old Farmer may have forfeited a scholarship and his future when he attacked his ex-girlfriend in her apartment building in Bedford Heights on April 23rd. This surveillance video obtained by the Fox 8 I-team shows Farmer striking Andrea Lane in the head and then continuing to strike and kick the 18-year-old as she cowered in a corner and pleaded for him to stop. But police say he dragged her outside by the hair and continued to assault her. Then, when she tried to get back inside the apartment building, he attacked her again, tried to pull her outside, and later kicked her in the head 4 times.
I don't know what was wrong with him that day. I know he was a good person. I hope he still is. I hope he learns from this.
Court orders that the defendant shall serve a term of 2 years on that as well.
Tony Farmer collapsed in court on Tuesday after Judge Pamela Barker sentenced him to 3 years in prison on charges that include kidnapping and felonious assault.
And your version was, I got into a fight with my ex-girlfriend.
In an interview with the I-team, Judge Barker says she was not swayed by supporters of Tony Farmer, who asked that she be lenient so that he could pursue a basketball scholarship. She was also not swayed by the victim's request that he not be sent to prison.
He really needs help. Think Jill would give him that.
There's nothing in the sentencing guideline that talks about him being a basketball star and being able to go forward when obviously I think she's been very traumatized by this whole situation.
The judge says she also concluded that Tony Farmer was not remorseful after his initial arrest because he later attempted to intimidate the victim by sending her a series of text and phone messages.
He certainly threatened her or said that he should have done something more to her, and so that, in addition to what I saw on the tape, was very telling to me, and it was a violation of the no-contact order that was put in place to protect her.
The defendant is ordered to the custody of the sheriff for transport to the Lorain Correctional Institution for evaluation as to transfer.
And as Tony Farmer heads to prison, the judge says he only has himself to blame for the cloud that now hangs over his once bright future.
The opportunities that were lost, I would just say that he lost them.